Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you QAM, Quadrature Amplitude Modulation, in this session. Now see, before we start with this session, I would like to ask you one question. That is our quiz question for this session. And you just write your answer in comments. In next session, I'll explain that answer. Right, so the question is, QAM and PSK is there with us. Which system is having better noise immunity at same power? Right, so we have two scheme, QAM and PSK. Our agenda is to identify noise immunity with respect to same power at transmitter side. So this is my question. You write down your answer in comments, and in next session I'll explain how those things are there. Right, so let us begin this session with QAM. Now see, QAM is quadrature amplitude modulation, and this is what we are utilizing in digital modulation as well as analog modulation. In digital modulation, we have combination of PSK and ASK to have quadrature amplitude modulation, and in analog modulation we have a combination of phase modulation and amplitude modulation. And see, I'll explain you this by first transmitter, and then we will see what will be my resultant signal, and then I'll explain you QAM at receiver, and we will detect those signal which is what we are transmitting. Right, so both of those things that I'll be going to derive, and at the end I'll explain how constellation diagram is there with QAM. So see, when we talk about quadrature amplitude modulation, its name is quadrature amplitude modulation because of here we have two carrier signal which are there in quadrature phase. Right, so see, as per the name, carrier signal, let us say we have a carrier signal C of T, right, and that is A cos omega CT. So that is what we are translating into quadrature phase. Now see how to translate that in quadrature phase. So that we can translate into quadrature phase as per, see over here, there will be A cos omega CT, and if I provide 90 degree phase, in that case over here my phase will be A sin omega CT because of 90 degree phase shift has been provided. Now see, here in QAM we have two signals over here, let us say X1T and X2T, and that signal that we give it over here to this product modulator. Now as you give this to product modulator, you will be finding at this side, there will be DSBSC output, right? There will be DSBSC output, double sideband suppress carrier, and all we will be doing is we will combine this. So we will add both of these signals, and my resultant signal that will be S of T. And that is what we are dealing with to transmit. Right, now first thing that is we are dealing with to understand, what is this DSBSC output? That is just a multiplication of inputs as per product modulator, right? So this output, this my first DSBSC output, that will be X1T into A cos omega CT, and my second DSBSC output, that is X2T into A sin omega CT, and this is just an adder, so we'll add it and my S of t, that will be addition of these two. So here my output S of t, that is x1 t into a cos omega c t plus x2 t into a sin omega c t. Now see, this is what analog modulation type of diagram, right? But when it comes to digital, at that time we will be having digital to analog converter at input side, and that will represent amplitude as x1t and x2t, and that is what we will give it to product modulator, and we will do same thing. Like see, for example, here if I have digital data, then first we'll convert this into serial to parallel. Let us say serial to parallel converter is there. After that, once we have serial to parallel conversion, after that there will be digital to analog converter. And that is what we will give it as x1t and x2t. So in digital modulation, this is what the difference which we do, right? So first digital data that we convert into parallel, and then digital to analog converter data that we give it over here. So that is what the case which we do it in digital communication, right? So same thing is been there. Now this is what my transmitted data, and you can observe over a same channel we are utilizing bandwidth effectively, right? So here we occupy very less bandwidth. Like see, in DSBAC you need bandwidth which is FM, right? But here two DSBAC signal that we are transmitting over a same channel, so here we optimize utilization of bandwidth, right? Now this is what transmitted signal, that is S of t. Now let us see what will happen at receiver side. So here we have received signal S of t, right? Let us say that is S of t. Now this received signal, that is what we will again give it to product modulator, and product modulator second input, that will be carrier signal, which is again quadrature in phase, right? So here we have one product modulator, here we have second product modulator. Let us say we have a carrier signal generator over here, cos omega ct. One is directly giving it over here, and second is given after 90 degree phase shift. So this will be sine omega ct, and over here it will be cos omega ct, right? And as per this product modulator, let us say this is generating y1 dash of t, and let us say this is generating y2 dash of t, right? And after that we'll pass this through low pass filter. So over here you'll be finding this low pass filter that is having, let us say, y1t output, and that has to be half of a of x1t, and if you pass this y2 dash of t through low pass filter, you'll be finding this will be y2t, that is equals to half of a x2 of t. Now let us try to understand how that is coming. So we will derive that over here. So see, y1 dash of t, so let me write y1 dash of t, so that will be s of t into cos omega ct, right? S of t into cos omega ct. Now what is s of t? That is this. So let us write it x1t a cos omega ct plus x2t a sin omega ct into cos omega ct. So let us multiply cos omega ct inside. So this will be x1t into a cos square omega ct plus this will be now x2t into a sin omega ct cos omega ct. Now let us further simplify this. So see, cos square omega ct, that is 1 plus cos 2 omega ct by 2. So x1t a, and this is 1 plus cos 2 omega ct by 2 plus, now you see, if I multiply 2 and divide 2, then 2 sin omega ct cos omega ct, that is 2, that is sin 2 omega ct. So I will be doing this x2t a by 2. So multiply 2, that will make 2 sin omega ct cos omega ct is equals to sin 2 omega ct. So let us further simplify this. So this will be x1t into a by 2 plus this will be x1t a by 2 into cos 2 omega ct plus x2t into a by 2 into sin 2 omega ct. So see, this is my y1 dash of t, that is over here. Now when you pass this through low pass filter, you will be eliminating high frequency component. So you will eliminate this component as well as this component once you pass it through low pass filter. So after low pass filter, your y1t, now that will be x1 of a by 2, right? And same thing that we can have it for y2t, you just do it by yourself. You'll be finding it is half of a x2 of t, right? Now let us draw 4QAM. So I'll draw 4QAM pattern over here first. Now in this QAM pattern, we can say this is what in phase and this is quadrature in phase, right? And first we will plot 4QAM. So that is having constellation point, that is over here, here, here and here, right? And we can say this is there regarding 0, 0, this is there regarding 0, 1, 1, 1 and 1, 0. See, that is how two bits are representing one constellation point. But if you observe this diagram for 4QAM and 4PSK, right, then that will be same. Like for 4PSK, even same diagram is there. So sometimes students are getting confused. What is the difference? So to understand difference in between PSK and QAM, let me draw 16 QAM diagram, so it will be more clear. So now I'll draw 16 QAM diagram. You see this. Let me draw it in this diagram only. So by this color, I'll draw 16 QAM diagram, right? So see, you'll be finding those constellation points that will be like this. So this is how QAM is there, where you can see with respect to center, distance is amplitude. So here amplitude is changing as well as phase is changing, right? So in this we can say this is what a combination of amplitude shift keying and phase shift keying. While for 4QAM, you can see with respect to center, distance is same. So there is nothing which is done in terms of amplitude shift keying. Amplitude is constant, but for 16 QAM, one can say it is a combination of amplitude you can see there are three different levels. Like, see, this distance that gives you idea about one amplitude level, this distance that gives you idea about another amplitude level, and third amplitude level, that is this distance. You can see. So that is how amplitude is there, and phase, that is different for all. You can see it over here, right? So this is all about quadrature amplitude shift keying. And one more thing that we need to understand, that is decision boundaries, right? So see, I'm just making decision boundaries over here. So in these boundaries, you'll be finding decisions are there, where it represents this bit has been received, right? And for 16K, all constellation points are having 4-bit representation, right? So decision boundaries, that is very nearer to each other, that you can see. For 4QAM, decision boundaries were bigger, right? The reason is it was just representing 2 bits per constellation point. So that is what the case which we need to understand. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll make videos which will solve your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.